साली हिमोमिटर भन्छ यहाँ लेखेको छ साली हिमोमिटर यो जस्ट बक्सलाई के भन्छ कम्पेरेटर बक्स है कम्पेरेटर बक्स यसमा यो ग्लासलाई ब्राउन टिन्टेड ग्लास भन्छ है ब्राउन कलरको छ ब्राउन टिन्टेड ग्लास र यो व्हाइट छ यसलाई व्हाइट अपुलुसेन्ट ग्लास अर व्हाइट ट्रान्सलुसेन्ट ग्लास भन्छ ठिक छ दिस इज फोर डिफ्युजन अफ लाइट डिफ्युजन मतलब होमोजिनस डिफ्युजन अफ लाइट डाइरेक्ट लाइटमा हेर्नु हुँदैन डिफ्युज लाइटमा कम्पेयर गर्नलाई ओके नाउ दिस इज द वाट सालिज ट्युब अर एडम्स ट्युब होइन यो स्टिरर अर्को चाहिँ के छ हेमोग्लोबिन पिपेट सो दिस इज द हेमोग्लोबिन पिपेट यसमा मार्किङ राम्रो छैन ओके मेटिसकेको यहाँ हुन्छ 20 माइक्रो लिटर है यहाँ मार्क छ हल्का देखिरहेछ 20 माइक्रो लिटर मार्क हुन्छ दिस इज द हेमोग्लोबिन पिपेट है हेमोग्लोबिन इस्टिमेसन सालिज मेथडबाट गर्दाखेरि फर्स्ट यु हेभ टु टेक एन बाई टेन एचसिएल दिस इज द एचसिएल सो युज ड्रोपर एन्ड किप एन बाई टेन एचसिएल अप टु 2 ग्राम पर्सेन्ट यहाँ एउटा ग्राम पर्सेन्ट छ एउटा पर्सेन्ट मात्रै छ सो अप टु 2 ग्राम पर्सेन्ट यु हेभ टु किप द एन बाई टेन एचसिएल ओके देन बाई स्टराइल मेथड यु हेभ टु पङ्क्चर द फिङ्गर एन्ड देन कलेक्ट द ब्लड अप टु दिस 20 माइक्रो लिटर है यदि 20 भन्दा बढी आयो भने युज एज अफ द टेबल अर नेल बेड फोर रिमुभिङ द एक्स्ट्रा ब्लड है एक्स्ट्रा ब्लडलाई रिमुभ गर्ने एन्ड इट सुड बी अप टु ओन्ली 20 माइक्रो लिटर डु नट युज द दिस ब्लोटिङ पेपर अर कटन बिकज दिस सोक ओन्ली वाटर सो देयर बी हिमो कन्सन्ट्रेसन एन्ड इन्क्रिज रेड ब्लड सेल नम्बर सो जस्ट यु हेभ टु वाट युज द एज अफ द टेबल अर नेल बेड टु रिमुभ द एक्स्ट्रा blood okay so that will be the up to the 20 microliter then blow it into the this Adam's tube or this Salis tube okay blow it out and then wash this end edge of this tip of this pipette with that n by 10 HCl then remove it and use this stirrer to mix it after complete mixing keep it for the 10 minutes okay for the reaction between the acid and hemoglobin to form the acid hematin complex haina 10 minute samma chhod dinu so that all the acid will react with the hemoglobin and acid hematin complex will be formed okay after 10 minute use diluting fluid yasma n by 10 hcl use garna sakinchha athwa
distilled water
by dropper you can put this distilled water or n by 10 hcl and mix it and then you have to compare okay use the light towards the direct light you have to face it and then keep this stirrer above the solution and then compare okay and keep diluting till it matches so before matching you have to take one reading then at second reading at the matching and third reading just after matching so 3 readings and divide by 3 so take the average of these 3 readings so average value is taken as gram per deciliter reading garda khari yo purai na nikalne just yo mathi halka surface samma huda huncha and while taking reading you have to take the reading the value at the lower meniscus there is meniscus so not upper part you have to take the lower meniscus and then you have to take the value like in this you can see this is almost slightly less than 8 so 7.8 gram per deciliter or gram percent okay gram per deciliter or gram percent value isko likhne hai so this is hemoglobin estimation arko chahi blood grouping ko lagi you have to take the 4 clean glass slides okay then you have to make the sterile finger puncture okay write A, B, C, and D you can use another glass 4 glass one as mixer okay so A, B, C, and D so in A put 1 drop of blood in each slide we have to put 1 drop of blood okay then put anti A and mix with 1 is okay then put anti B on B slide and use another is to mix it okay then put NTD on D slide and mix with another S, and then use distilled water in C in control slide and mix it properly. After that, you have to see for the agglutination. If there is no agglutination in any slide, then it means this is O negative, O negative blood group. Okay. If there is agglutination only in D slide, so that is the O positive. If agglutination in A and D, then A positive. If agglutination in A and not in other slide, then A negative. If agglutination in B and not in other slide, then B negative. If agglutination in B and D, then B positive. Okay, so this is for blood grouping. BT RCT को लागि ब्लीडिंग टाइम वी परफॉर्म बाय ड्यूक मेथड है ना ड्यूक मेथड सो क्या कर कोई तो फिल्टर पेपर फिल्टर पेपर में यूज करने है सो आफ्टर पंक्चर यू हैव टू कीप द ब्लड ड्रॉ आफ्टर पंक्चर यू कैन यूज आफ्टर 30 सेकेंड और जस्ट इमीडिएटली आफ्टर पंक्चर ओके सो इफ यू व्हेन यू कीप immediately after the puncture, then you have to calculate by n minus 1 into 30. And if you keep the blood after 30 seconds, then n into 30 will be the value for the bleeding time. Okay. While touching this, while keeping the blood on the blotting paper, you have to keep in mind the fingers should not be touched into the blotting paper. Okay. Just the surface of the drop should be touched into the blotting paper. Okay, so likewise, we have to do n minus 1 into 30 and then calculate the total bleeding time. Okay, so that is for the bleeding time by the Duke method. Now, another is clotting time by the what?
Clotting time?
Capillary tube method. Okay, capillary tube method. So, this is. Okay, so this is the capillary tube, isn't it? So by making the sterile precaution, you have to puncture again and make the large drop, and then you have to keep this slightly downward, okay, 45 degree at a 45 degree angulation, and keep this surface just lower surface of the drop, so that all the blood will flow into the capillary, okay, by capillary action. So 2/3 of this capillary tube should be filled with the blood. 2/3 of this capillary length, tube length, should be filled with the blood. There should be no air entrapment. So to avoid entrapment of the air, you have to make the large blood drop, and this should be always in contact with the blood drop. Okay, so that there will be continuous flow of the blood and no air entrapment. Okay, and you have to note the time while you are filling this. Okay, and then keep it for the 2 minutes, and then start breaking in every 30 second, and so look for the thread where the thread is formed. Okay, then you have to calculate 2 minute plus n minus 1 into 30. Okay, so that will be the clotting time. Okay, then what left? ESR PCB. So PCB and ESR will not be in the procedure. So there will be a ready-made preparation for this PCB and ESR, but it will be on a spot. Okay, so this is the Wintrop's tube. So ESR can be measured by Wintrop's method and Westergren method. So this is the Westergren tube and Westergren rack, all these things. Okay, so this is when you take ESR by this method, then Westergren method. When you take ESR by Wintrop method, Wintrop tube, so Wintrop method. Okay, and Wintrop tube can be used for the PCB also, paxial bottom. That's why there are two markings in this Wintrop tube. One is from 0 to 10, up to down, 0 to 10. Another is from below to up, 0 to 10. Okay, so from up to down is for the ESR, and from below to upward is for PCB. Okay, so after this blood is kept in this PCB, will be ready made, and then you have to take the value for the PCB. So from the lower to upward. Suppose up to this 40, up to 40 there is blood column, okay, along with the buffy coat. You have to take the reading along with the buffy coat. That is for the white blood cells, okay. So along with the this buffy coat, we have to take the PCB value. Suppose it is up to the 46, then you have to take the 46%, okay, PCB. And in the same tube, you can do the ESR. Suppose you kept the blood and then kept it for 1 hour, then you have to see how much length is length the blood cells are sedimented. Okay, so you have to take the from reading from the upward, okay, up to downward. Suppose this column of plasma up to 4, this up to 4, okay, then you have to calculate 10, 20, 30, 40, so 40 millimeter per hour. Suppose in 1 hour only 10 millimeter has fall down, so 10 millimeter per hour. If 20 mm in 2 hour, then 20 mm per 2 hour. Like this, you have to write down the value for the what? ESR, okay, from this wind drop. Similarly in Westergren method, we have to take the reading from up to down. So you have to note down, suppose up to this zero, up to zero mark will be the all the blood and blood filled initially, then kept for 1 hour, and then there will be sedimentation of blood cells. So blood cells will be sedimented down and leaving the plasma in the upper level. So the plasma level you have to read out, and whether it is fall down up to the 40 or 20, likewise you have to write down the 20 millimeter per hour or 40 millimeter per hour. Okay, while doing procedure, suppose in 1 hour there is no fall of the blood cells, so no sedimentation of the red blood cells, then we have to wait for another hour. Okay, so in second hour you have to write down the value. Okay, if again not sedimented, then you have to write the normal value. If there is no sedimentation, you can take the, this is the normal value. 0 millimeter hour is also the normal value, because in range you can see in drops 0 to 5, 0 to 3, like that. Okay, so 0 is also the normal for the ESR. Okay, now what next? Blood ko sakyo hai na? अर्को चाहिँ स्पाइरोमिटर छ. स्पाइरोमिटरमा अब त्यही देखाउनु पर्ला है. स्पाइरोमिटर हाम्रो स्पाइरोमिटर स्टुडेन्ट्स स्पाइरोमिटर हो. यो बाइटालो मिटर पनि भन्छ यसलाई, बिकज वी युज दिस स्पाइरोमिटर टु मेजर द बाइटल क्यापेसिटी ओन्ली. सो दिस इज अल्सो नोन एज द बाइटालो मिटर. ओके, वाइल कमेन्सिङ द टेस्ट यु हेभ टु चेक द एपरेटस केयरफुली. द सेन्ट्रल ड्रम सुड नोट toss to the any side of the outer drum. It should be in the center, okay, to avoid the friction. Okay, then water should be kept at the 2/3 level. Okay, in the outer drum there will be water, so it should be at the 2/3 level. Okay, then zero in the reading pulling, you have to keep the marker at the zero and then blow it. While blowing, you have to give the proper instruction for vital capacity. Kya garne vital capacity ko lagi kasari garne ho. First, take the deep inspiration, okay, and then expire maximally with forced expiration. You can expire forcefully, okay. First, take the, fill your lungs with the air by taking deep inspiration, maximum inspiration. Then, take it in the mouthpiece. Into your mouth, close your nose and blow it out forcefully. Okay, and take the reading. So whether it is 4000 ml or 3500 ml. Okay, so we have to take the three readings, and among the three readings, the highest value you have to take as the vital capacity. Do not average over here. Okay, you have to take the highest reading for the vital capacity among the three readings. Okay, so that is the for the vital capacity. So you have to do in different posture, like in sitting posture, then in standing erect posture, and even in the lying down posture, and you have to compare the battle capacity in which posture it is highest and why. ओके यति हो भाइटल क्यापेसिटीमा. अर्को चाहिँ यसको ब्लड प्रेसर मेजर गर्दाखेरि, ब्लड प्रेसर मेजर गर्दाखेरि तिमीहरूले ध्यान दिनुपर्ने हो. सबभन्दा पहिला यु हेभ टु डु पाल्पेट्री मेथड बिफोर द स्कल्टेट्री मेथड है. पाल्पेट्री मेथड वाइ टु डिटेक्ट द सिस्टोलिक ब्लड प्रेसर फर्स्ट. त्यसपछि के गर्ने, स्पिगोमेनोमिटरको कफ बाँध्दाखेरि कहाँ बाँध्ने, one inch above the cubital fossa, and it should be snugly fitted, neither too tight nor too loose. Okay, so just one finger should go inside. Okay, so it should be snugly fitted. Then you have to blow it and use the palpatory method. You will feel when blowing there will be disappear of this radial pulse, and again when you release the air pressure, then again there will be reappearance of the this pulse. So this the value where disappearance and reappearance occur, that will be the systolic blood pressure in the palpatory method. Then you have to use the scultatory method. While scultatory, you have to keep the this chest piece diaphragm at the medial aspect of the cubital fossa over the brachial arch, isn't it? Then again blow up to 180 or 200, then slowly release the air. Okay, so that 1 to 2 millimeter of mercury column will fall in a second. Okay, like that you have to release the slowly, then take the, if the first heart sound is heard, that will be for the systolic blood pressure, and where the sound is disappeared, that will be for the diastolic blood pressure in the scultatory method. In oscillatory method, same as the scultatory, but you have to see the oscillation of the mercury column in the mercury manometer. Okay, the where the oscillation starts, that will be the systolic blood pressure, and disappearance of oscillation will be diastolic blood pressure. So that is the measurement of blood pressure, okay, by all method. Okay, then another is you have to see the effect of exercise on the blood pressure. Okay, effect of exercise. So for the exercise, you have to do the mild to moderate exercise. Okay, how minute exercise? 5 minutes. Okay, so you can do the jogging over there. Okay, jump for 5 minutes. So before starting the exercise, you have to take this blood pressure. Okay, blood pressure, that will be the resting stage blood pressure, and after that commence the exercise, and then take the blood pressure just after the stoppage of exercise. Then after 1 minute, okay, then after 2 minutes, after 4 minutes, then 5 minutes. Okay, so we have to take. So what will the effect of moderate exercise in blood pressure, mild, moderate and severe exercise? In mild, both the systolic and diastolic will be increased. In moderate, systolic will be increased, diastolic may be increased or maybe at the normal level. In severe, systolic increase, diastolic decrease. Okay, so this is for the blood pressure and effect of exercise on blood pressure. Now another practical, aur kya auscultation of heart sound. Okay, for heart sound you have to know the different areas. There are different areas for the auscultation of heart sound, that is known as the scultatory areas. Okay, so there are mitral areas, tricuspid areas, okay, then aortic and pulmonary areas. Is that it? Aortic and pulmonary areas. So you know the area located, where it is located, aortic and pulmonary, in second intercostal space, in left side is the aortic areas, just at the edge, and on the right side pulmonary. Okay, then in the fifth intercostal space, about 4 to 5 centimeter beyond the medium sternal, lateral to the sternal. Okay, in the fifth intercostal space, that is the mitral area. Another is tricuspid area, that is in the fifth intercostal space at the margin of the this sternum. Okay, so fifth intercostal space, how will you reach in the fifth intercostal space? So you know there is external angle, which is known as the manubrio external angle or angle of Lewis, isn't it? When you palpate, there is elevated portion in the sternum. So that is the elevated portion is the junction between the manubrium and sternum, head of the sternum. Okay, so that is the angle of Lewis. If you go along this, then you can feel the space, that is the second intercostal space. Then just feel this going through the third intercostal space, then feel another intercostal space, okay, go like fourth, then fifth, then about 4 to 5 centimeters beyond this, then that will be the mitral areas. Okay, then in the fifth intercostal space, just near this sternum, that is the tricuspid. In second, this side aortic, right side pulmonary. Okay, you have to know the significance of different areas. In mitral areas, which sound is heard clearly. In tricuspid area, which sound is heard clearly. In pulmonary and aortic, which sound heard clearly. Okay, that is for the heart sound. And apart from this, we have to know all the how this physiology behind the production of heart sound. जो ना हमें पहले discuss करी सकियो है ना? Okay, discuss करी सकियो. तो वे heart sound. और क्या सा? Breath sound को लागी. Breath sound को लागी supraclavicular areas, infraclavicular areas, mammary area र inframammary area. क्यों करता करी अब इसमें जाने mid clavicular line में supraclavicular, infraclavicular गर्ने त्यसपछि साइमल्टेनियस यता गरेछौ भने यता पनि गर्ने यहाँ छ भने यहाँ पनि गर्ने यसरी गरेर बायलेटरली सिमेट्रिकली साउन्ड सुन्ने यु हैव टू एडवाइस द सब्जेक्ट ओके टू टेक बाथ डीप ब्रीदिंग ओके विथ स्लाइट माउथ ओपन ओके अनि त्यसपछि बायलेटरली सिमेट्रिकल गर्ने मिड एक्सिलरी में करने बायलेटरली करने पछाड़ी करने बायलेटरली करने मिड इंटर स्कैपुलर एरियाज में करने इंटर स्कैपुला पछाड़ी तीर दुईटा स्कैपुला को बीच में जैसे यह पोर्सन आयो स्कैपुलर एरियाज यो स्कैपुलर यो इंटर स्कैपुलर एरियाज में करने बायलेटरली बायलेटरली सिमेट्रिकल फोर द भेसिकुलर साउंड एंड ब्रोंकियल साउंड है ना भेसिकुलर ब्रेथ साउंड ब्रोंकियल ब्रेथ साउंड है भेसिकुलर साउंड अरु लंग्स को अरु पार्ट में भेसिकुलर साउंड हो लार्ज एयरवेज बाट आने साउंड चाहे ब्रोंकियल ब्रेथ साउंड तो तुम ट्रैकिया में राखे सुनने दैट इज द ब्रोंकियल ब्रेथ साउंड
मतलब के भन्छ
प्रोसिडर भन्यो त्यसपछि ब्रोंकियल ब्रेथ साउन्ड के हो कहाँबाट आउँछ भनेर सोच्छ सो ब्रोंकियल ब्रेथ साउन्ड
गरेर देखाउनु पर्छ
हैन कहाँबाट आउँछ लार्ज एयरवेजबाट आउँछ ट्राकिया त्यसपछि ब्रोंकाई हैन र स्मल एयरवेजबाट आउने साउन्ड चाहिँ भेसिकुलर ब्रेथ साउन्ड हो दिस आर द नर्मल ब्रेथ साउन्ड एब नर्मलमा धेरै कुरा आउँछ के अरे रोंकाई आउँछ है अरू के आउँछ क्विज आउँछ There are crackle sounds, so there are several pathological sounds, but you have to know only the physiological sounds. That is the bronchial and vascular breath sound. Bronchial sounds are trachea or bronchi bata. So trachea ma direct rakhne, chest piece, diaphragm ma sunne, aur ko chahe, aur different locations ma jun pehla bana. Okay? Yeti ho trachea. और उसका की प्रैक्टिस आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ सेल है स्पॉट में आइडेंटिफिकेशन में न्यूट्रोफिल्स त्यसपछि इयोसिनोफिल है स्मॉल लिम्फोसाइट्स र मोनोसाइट यो राख्न सकिन्छ अब सबभन्दा पहिला हेर्ने सेल लाई जस्तै अब न्यूट्रोफिल्स को छ भने पहिला ब्याकग्राउन्ड हेर्ने ब्याकग्राउन्ड में देयर विल बी सो मेनी आरबीसी सेल्स रेड ब्लड सेल्स यू हैव टू कंपेयर द साइज ऑफ द सेल फर्स्ट ओके size of the cell so you know neutrophil is almost double than that of the red blood cell ko kati huncha 7 to 8 micron ra neutrophils ko 14 hai na bhane pachi almost double size ko cha tespachi nucleus herne nucleocytoplasmic ratio herne
yei haru
haina ho nucleus herne nucleus ma aba लोब हेर्ने लोब कति लोबको छ त्यसपछि न्युक्लियस जोडेको हेर्ने थिक ब्यान्डले जोडेको छ कि फाइन थ्रेडले जोडेको छ फाइन थ्रेडले जोडेको छ भने द्याट इज द न्युट्रोफिल इफ मोर देन टू लोब्स एन्ड जोइन्ड बाई फाइन थ्रेड द्याट इज द न्युट्रोफिल्स है त्यसपछि उसको साइटोप्लाजममा हेर्ने साइटोप्लाजममा फाइन पिङ्क ग्रानुल्स छ भने द्याट इज फर द न्युट्रोफिल्स युसिनोफिलमा के हुन्छ बाइलोब्ड हुन्छ थिक ब्यान्ड अफ थिक ब्यान्डले जोडेको हुन्छ जस्ट लाइक सो न्युक्लियस विल रिजेम्बल्स लाइक स्पेक्टाकल्स इजन्ट इट देयर विल बी कोर्सर ब्रिक रेड कलर ग्रानुल्स होइन साइटोप्लाज्ममा बेसोफिल्समा के हुन्छ मेबी बाइलोब्ड आवर ट्राइलोब आवर हर्सो सेप्ड Okay, nucleus is not distinguished when you see in the microscope because all the these granules are studded over the nucleus also. Cytoplasma or nucleus ma pani huncha granules haru. That granules are very bluish dark colored and that is studded over the nucleus also. So nucleus may not be visible clearly in the basophil. Size are the same as the neutrophil, eosinophil and basophil. Thik chha? Monocyte ko herda keri monocyte ko size सबभन्दा ठुलो हुन्छ दिस इज अलमोस्ट डबल देन द्याट अफ द इभन न्युट्रोफिल युसिनोफिल एन्ड बेसोफिल है त्यति लार्ज साइजको हुन्छ न्युक्लियस साइटोप्लाजम रेसियो हेर्ने 50-50 रेसियोमा हुन्छ हर्सो सेपरेट न्युक्लियस हुनसक्छ है डम्बेल सेपरेट हुनसक्छ मोनोसाइटको बट न्युक्लियोसाइटोप्लाज्मिक रेसियो हेर्ने 50-50% हुन्छ 50% अकुपाई गरेको हुन्छ न्युक्लियसले र 50% साइटोप्लाजम हुन्छ साइटोप्लाजम युजुअली दे आर द क्लियर साइटोप्लाजम होइन ग्रानुल्स हुन तर समटाइम्स एबाउट 20% अफ द मोनोसाइटमा स्मल ग्रानुल्स पनि हुनसक्छ है सो मेन के हेर्ने न्युक्लियोसाइटोप्लाज्मिक रेसियो साइज देन के अरे साइज अफ द सेल होल देन ग्रानुल्स यो कुरा हेर्ने आइडेन्टिफिकेसनको लागि नाउ फर द स्मल लिम्फोसाइट्स एन्ड लार्ज लिम्फोसाइट्स स्मल लिम्फोसाइट्समा यु क्यान सी द सेल्स आर कम्पेरेबल टु रेड ब्लड सेल रेड ब्लड सेलकै साइजको सेल हुन्छ द्याट इज द स्मल लिम्फोसाइट्स बट दिज आर द न्युक्लिएटेड एन्ड दिस न्युक्लियस अकुपाई मोर देन 90% अफ द सेल ओके सो ओन्ली यु क्यान सी जस्ट अफ वन साइड अफ द साइटोप्लाजम अर पेरिफेरल रिम अफ द साइटोप्लाजम इज देयर एन्ड दिस साइटोप्लाजम इज क्लियर सो 90% अफ द सेल इज अकुपाइड बाई द न्युक्लियस ओके एन्ड ओन्ली थिन रिम अफ द साइटोप्लाजम विल बी देयर द्याट विल बी क्लियर साइटोप्लाजम सो दिस इज फोर स्मल लिम्फोसाइट्स साइज इज जस्ट कम्पेरेबल टु द रेड ब्लड सेल लार्ज लिम्फोसाइट्स size are larger than small lymphocytes it is the size is just like the neutrophils double than that of the what RBC and nuclear cytoplasmic ratio again more than 90% so more than 90% of the cell will be occupied by the nucleus so one side there will be just one side small clear cytoplasm and rest of the cell will be occupied by the nucleus okay so this is how we have to identify Now you have to know the condition for each cell, for neutrophil, one physiological condition and one pathological condition for increase and decreasing condition. For each cell you have to know basophil, eosinophil, neutrophil, small lymphocyte and monocyte. Right? Yathi kura practical. Maru sir, ki?